Now let me add multi-states to convert the gauges in the collection into visual alarms. I'm going to modify it first. Choose a symbol that I want to act as a multi-state. And then right-click it and choose Add Multi-State. I'm only interested in three temperature states. So I'll remove these. And the top one I'll make red. The middle one is going to be orange. And the bottom one is going to be green. I'll exit Modify Mode. And now the color of the needle tells me the state of the temperature. The red arrow indicates the pumps whose temperature is out of spec. So I can easily tell which pumps are having a problem. I also have a plant in Springfield, so I'm going to recreate this collection for my Springfield plant. I'll go back to Design Mode, select the image and the collection, and then hit Copy and Paste, and move these to the side. I'm going to copy-paste my label. Place it here and rename it. Now I need to find the pumps for my Springfield collection. So I'm going to modify the collection by changing its collection criteria. And under search route, I'm going to change the route from Philadelphia to Springfield. And when I hit refresh, I should be able to see my Springfield pumps inside the collection. Great. Display gives me the situational awareness I need to monitor assets across both sites. But what if I want my collections to show me only the pumps with the out-of-spec temperature? To do that, I'll need to change the collection criteria again. I'll right-click, and then under Asset Type, I'm going to choose the asset attribute, which is bearing temperature, change the operator to greater than, and it's going to be 160, which is my threshold temperature. Hit refresh and do the same for this second collection. Now the collections will automatically update to show me only the pumps whose bearing temperature requires my immediate attention. So if I go back in time, they're going to update. In the future, if new assets get added to my AF hierarchy, I don't have to worry about adding them to my collection. PyVision will pick up the new assets automatically as long as their data falls within my criteria. Let me save the display. Now that I have this auto-updating dashboard, I want to add navigational links from the collection to my original single asset pump display that we created in the previous video. That way I can get more detailed information about the pumps whose bearing temperatures out of spec. To add a link, I'll modify the collection. I'm going to select the symbol that I want to act as a link, right-click it, and choose Add Navigation Link. On this pane, I could link my symbols to a website by typing a URL right here. For example, I can link to a workflow website for my maintenance crew, but I want to link to another display, so I'm going to hit Search for Displays and choose my display, which is called Pump Conditions. I'd like to open it in a new tab, so I'll select this checkbox. And I'm definitely going to keep these ones on because I want to preserve the asset context, which means that when I click Pump 1 on that collection, I'm going to be automatically taken to the Pump 1 single asset display. So let's test this. I'll exit Modify Mode, and I'm going to double-click the symbol. This is awesome. The navigational link lets me drill into the pump that's overheating, analyze its process parameters, and instantly share this information with my maintenance crew who are using PyVision out in the field on a mobile device.